yourself in a field band?
My name's Amos, and I play bass.
Alright, so this tour is pretty much almost over. Like, how is the tour that you guys?
It's been awesome. This is the second tour in 1 month. Because the first 2 weeks that we were in the States, we did a tour in Catatonia, Orpheum, and Regional. And that was us supporting Catatonia. And then once that finished up in San Francisco, we jumped to Vancouver and started the Netherlands tour, which has just been awesome to be able to come out here after not being here for 2 years, maybe 2 and a bit years, and to have pretty much every show close to sell out. Last night and sold out, which is fantastic. It's just amazing to come back home for such a long time.
Out of the tour package with Scale 7 Ancients come together, did you guys handpick those bands or was it just kind of thrown together?
We all shared the same agent, and that was good to us quite early on. So I thought, okay, I'll put you guys out. Really awesome. Ancients, who at the time didn't know, and Scale 7. Our agents has put this together and been really quite a long tour. It seems like everybody's doing that really well. And we absolutely love the other 2 months because it's exciting to have to be on the road and to enjoy the they're really cool guys and they play really good music. It's good to see a band like Ancients being received very well because they're a very different style as like an old school.
States has been out for about 5 months now. Like, how has the reception been before?
Unbelievable. We've already outsold the first album. So, one was released in like 2000, I think. And we've already surpassed those sales. We've made 3 or 4 months of the state of the past now. So, that's a phenomenal response. We didn't expect it. We expected it to be just the same reaction. One has gone along a lot further than we realized. It would just love what we're doing now, which is really encouraging for the future, as well as continuing to get that sort of more melodic edge instead of the gent style that everybody else is really wanting to head off in a different direction. This was the risk we chose to take with this album. Okay, well, we've got nothing to lose. We've established that name. Out there and be in band we want to be instead of trying to fit in to something. So we're very lucky that we like the modern side of things.
Altered State, yeah, I think 94 on the Billboard Top 200. Does something like that surprise you or did you expect it?
We didn't expect to crack the Top 200. And certainly in iTunes, the Metro chart in America and in Canada, we were number one and number two both versions. The first 3 or 4 days that it was out, it was just about it's incredible. We were very lucky because there was a lot out like as well. Like Alice in Chains released their own, we weren't overshadowed by that. Luckily, it life in general, everything from being wrong. So the first movement is called singularity, and the second is called echoes. So it's from as far back as you could ever imagine the beginning of time until the universe laid down into slowly down. So, a little bit depressing maybe, but it's kind of reality.
What is the best concert you've ever attended that you didn't play?
1993 or 1994 in London, Slayer headlined, Sepultura or 1994, Bassist headlined. Honestly, three bands as good as they could be at that time. It was just incredible. I mean, Derek had been in Sepultura for like 2 years, and it was just unbelievable. Stage presence was ignited the whole crowd. Slayer, obviously, saying is every time you spell nothing, sadly, because obviously Jim Hammond's died, but every time they played that lineup, it was always one to the point of the seven and the start of the and then System of a Down, no idea at the time, and they were like this crazy fireball energy on the stage. So that was, I've always been in my mind, which is really
phenomenal. What are some of your favorite musical releases?
This year, I'm still trying to get into Carnival's new album, The Symmetry. I haven't had the time to sit down and listen to it, but that was what I was looking forward to. Oh god, I've been so wrapped up in my own album, I'm not listening to much else from contemporary stuff. Okay, what's been some of the biggest releases this year?
I mean, the new skill is so much more.
Yeah, I've been hearing that every night, basically. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And I like that. It's a very good album.
I don't know if you're into that kind of stuff, but one of my favorites is Dev Evans' album.
So is that instrumental music?
No, it's like ambient post-rock, but it has black metal vocals on it.
Oh, right.
It's really, really weird.
Sound guy Chris, he's been trying to introduce me to Bang for the Low Brother. He's seen them on tour. That sounds monstrous, like just huge, and it's not heavy, but it's just like ambient post-rock, like just really,
it's a great album.
I really have to check it out. I think one of them is a gig last night, so it's a couple of them. I'd like to tour with them, because I think they're a great band. I'd love to tour on the stage with them.
Alright, after this tour is over, what's next for Tesseract?
We have like 1 day off, and then we're in Mexico for 3 or 4 days. Then we fly back, and then another 2 or 3 days off, and then we tour in Carnival in the UK. Then we're gonna, I think we're about doing some writing for like Christmas, unless we've had a little bit of break. But then on like January 5th, we start touring the Protest of the Hero, which is gonna be awesome. That's like a month in Europe. Then we head to Australia. It's a festival in town, which is huge. It's like, it's a touring festival, it's like 80,000 people every show. I think it's 5 or 6 shows. Then we head back to Europe, do some shows in Norway. And then it looks like we're coming back to the States in March, end of March, beginning of April. That needs to be